I'm afraid I'm winging this. Someone dropped out, and I volunteered myself to step in. So I'd like to just reflect on some of the work that we've been doing in the Learn department and with National Theatre Scotland over our 10 years. So this is what we do. We gather people in spaces and we connect people with artists to find stories that need to be told. Some statistics, I mentioned them earlier today, that we've been going for 10 years, and in that time we've played across the world, made over 200 productions, and playing to an audience of approaching 2 million. I might be wrong, someone will correct me. We do big projects. This is me looking into the abyss of the projects. Because we're very ambitious. We have to be, because the communities that we meet, as soon as we scratch the surface of who those communities are, they want to hear their voices heard loud and clear. These are some examples. We've created theatre in football stadiums. The one in the centre there with a group of young nine-year-olds playing as a half-time entertainment in Dunfermline, the most famous football match that was ever played in Dunfermline. Grown men cried. There was an audience of over 4,000. We rang telephones in shopping centres and in festival fields and asked people 20 questions. And we filmed them and recorded them. And we asked if some of what the some of their answers and some of their stories could be used in the pieces of theatre. We went to Aberdeen, which has got the most prohibitive signs per head of population anywhere in Scotland. Wonder why. And we asked kids what they wanted to do, and they said that we want to change the way that were things that were prohibited to do. So they made an installation on a hill in Aberdeen, telling them to shout back at the waves. Jump. Working with young boys who are making that transition into being adult men, and we used parkour as a physical aesthetic for them to be able to move and express themselves, but also tell the story of their growth. In Shetland, we toured the White Wife. This is who the White Wife is. She appears mysteriously in cars in the dark roads because there's no street lighting. Usually when guys have gone home from pubs, it's usually men, and she appears to them. She hitchhiked and collected stories in cars. Our Tin Forest, which was a Commonwealth Games project, we had a number of installations and events across the across Glasgow, but this is the favourite because we took a Clydesdale horse into the streets of Glasgow and collected old things that didn't have any more use and some stories along with it. The Yuva Ekta Foundation, Bangladesh Association of Glasgow are part of this festival. But that those relationships were built from another exchange that we did internationally. We worked in Dundee with this choir called Loads of Women Singing. Very apt. But it was part of quite an innovative approach to creating theatre across a city with an app that you downloaded to your iPhone, and it guided you around the city as a live piece of theatre. Tonight, you'll see the culmination of a project that was supported by British Council in partnership with us and Manifesto Jamaica. They're appearing tonight on stage in Glasgow. This was the beginning of that process and that journey with there were over 50 young Jamaican guys from a ghetto in Kingston. We work internationally with artists who are very interested in the work that we do, not just in National Theatre of Scotland, but in Scotland. I think it's really important that people hear, artists in Scotland hear how highly regarded the work that we all do is across the world. I mentioned Yuva Ekta. Yuva Ekta have already performed in the festival, but they are here and you can meet them if you care to stay for the programme later on. A wonderful company who work with street kids and connect them with well-off kids and create theatre with them. We work all across Scotland, I mentioned that. So in rural settings, from our most recent being in forests and in Wigtown, and cities, and any areas that there are communities that identify themselves and make the invitation for us to come. Alan Grieve, you will see him upstairs. If you haven't done this yet, go and do it. It's colouring in. It's so meditative and relaxing. He has an installation upstairs that you can influence. He's also a hairdresser. He cuts hair in exchange for stories, and he draws the stories on the windows, and that becomes a piece of theatre in itself. We worked in Aberdeen, where we asked people to reflect on their city, and we used the metaphor of the granite stone that it's synonymous with, the grit and the glint, to be able to draw stories from them. And then we recreated those stories in the Marshall College, which is a beautiful building. We're talking to Dundee about using their city as a space for a piece of theatre that is also working with the gaming industry in Dundee and Abertay University. We're calling it Play Dundee. It's a working title, but we're hoping that we'll take over the entire city as a theatre space. This is our new building, architect's drawing of it. If you go up to the canal and behind Spears Wharf, you'll see the actual real building. It's just about finished. We should be getting in a couple of weeks' time. So our theatre without walls is getting four walls. We're hungry for more. Anytime we go into a community, we always think of legacy from the very outset and make sure that this demand that communities make is met in some shape or form. If you're hungry for more, there's plenty more going on in this festival that you can connect with. Thank you very much.